Welcome to Why Should Watch. For those who don't know about Hannah, it is a TV show based on a 2011 movie. And for those who have watched the movie and haven't seen the show yet, well, the show has the same theme: gun battles, hand-to-hand combat, high-octane chases, mystery and intrigue. So let's talk about season 2 of Hannah. Hannah embraces a more ensemble perspective into the world of teen girl super soldiers in its stylish second season. As Amazon prepares to launch the second season of Hannah, creator David Farr proves that this show can stand out in a competitive market. Heading into Hannah season 2, we are well past the initial plot of the movie and the show, which was predictable. As in season 1, Hannah freed fellow genetically enhanced super soldier Clara. Her father Eric dies in the effort and Hannah carries that loss with her. As the season 2 starts, Hannah and Clara are living in the forest of Romania where she freed Clara. But Clara is restless and she wants to go out in the world and most importantly find her birth mother. Ironically, we can compare Hannah to Eric and Clara to Hannah in terms of overbearing parent and a rebellious teenager. Elsewhere, Marissa Wiegler is fighting the doubts amongst her colleagues, especially her new boss John Carmichael, who is not convinced that Marissa wasn't involved in the Utrex massacre. But he doesn't care about that much as long as it doesn't interfere with his end goals. Marissa can be a great ally to Hannah, but Hannah doesn't trust her, and Marissa does the same things as Eric by withholding the whole truth, which can be annoying at sometimes. But as season 1 was more on the father-daughter relationship and had a lot of emotions involved in that particular scenario, season 2 doesn't focus on any of those perspectives between any of the characters, which I liked cause I want the story to progress in a meaningful way. But Hannah season 2 doesn't put all of its eggs in one basket. We actually see the scope broadening of this world. Season 2 is much focused on the teenage assassins who didn't escape, and we see their next phase of training in Northern England called the Meadows, which gives you a little bit vibe of X-Men's Xavier School. Much of the show is filmed in this setting where teenage assassins get their license to kill graduation and are completely redefined with the help of fake names, fake families and a new wardrobe, again something very similar to Naked Weapon. Basically, the season 2 is season 1. In season 1, we see that Hannah is traveling and trying to find herself. And in season 2, we see the same things with other super soldiers, just on a bit of bigger scale. Basically, I would have preferred if they had taken the show the way Nikita was, cause Nikita didn't drag the same story each season, but actually came up with new and different ways to engage Nikita to take up the arms. I understand that a TV show has to have a broad spectrum in order to fill up all that filming time, unlike a 2-hour movie. But I think the show who try to drag the same narrative and doesn't bring diversity in terms of writing are doomed to fail. But I hope I'm wrong, because we need something new that doesn't belong to DC or Marvel. That was all. Like the video, comment and subscribe.